We're sitting in the cockpit of an A-22 Foxbat aircraft at runway 27 at Windrush International Airport. We're just about to do our run-ups and then we'll turn to the left and head off down the 1 in 10 slope on this very short runway. We've got about 200 meters of grass in front of us and take off for a joy flight to Bruny Island. As we come to the end of our climb now, we'll see a body of water open up to our left. Now that is the inlet into Port Signet, which was the original main port of this part of the world. Signet used to be a rather bigger town than Huonville until they built the bridge there. And we'll keep on going in this general direction, heading for where the eastern bank of the Huon River sort of becomes also the western bank of the Derwent. And as we level out and trot along here, you'll see Bruny Island appearing directly ahead. What we'll actually be aiming towards there is the southern part of Bruny Island. It's almost like two islands joined with a neck, and we'll be tracking directly for the southern island, south of the neck, and then we'll track along the neck and up into the aerodrome a little bit later on. as we head out over the expanse of water that separates the mainland of Tasmania from Bruny Island, you can see very clearly pretty much all of southern Bruny Island straight in front of you, and the very, very thin neck trailing off to forwards and to our left, which connects with the northern island, or the northern part of Bruny Island, which is our destination. The airport is just beyond the end of the neck, and what we'll do is we'll follow the neck along and then trek out to sea just a little bit, and then curve it to the left to land at the airstrip. as we've completed our descent down to circuit height, we're now beginning to head in towards the airport. If you look straight ahead, you can see a lagoon at the end of the neck, and that is at the entrance to the airstrip. The airstrip is heads off sort of diagonally to the left, forwards and to the left from that lagoon, from just beyond that lagoon, in fact. And what we're going to do is we're going to swing out to into the sea a little bit and then come in over the lagoon and land on the airstrip. As we make the final approach, I'm just going to lift the nose a little bit to slow us down so that I can most comfortably get full flaps on, and then we'll make our final approach and land on the airstrip. A nice, soft, comfortable touchdown. I'm not going to hit the brakes. We've got quite a long way to go, so I'm just going to let the propeller idle here and keep the nose wheel just off the ground and let us trundle on towards the parking space, which is at the far end of the airstrip.